Hey guys, it's Adrian from adriancgms.com, and in this series I'm gonna show you four different techniques for creating high poly object. If you go to my website adriancgms.com and search for technique for creating a high poly mesh, you end up with this article that I wrote explaining four different techniques for creating a high poly mesh. Alright, the first method is adding the support edge loop. You can apply these techniques and tools to other 3D packages like Maya, Blender or whatever. It's basically the same tools. Alright, we try to make this object high poly. If you look at it in the 3ds Max, this object it's a fairly complex shape. We have a circular on top followed by a box shape, another circular, we have a cylinder here, circular on the bottom. We have to be, you know, adding the support edge loop. That is very old and ancient techniques. This is not the best candidate for this type of model. You know, this method is time consuming and needs a lot of tweaking and cleanup, but we gotta make it work, right? Alright, in the 3ds Max, when I first look at this object, I see on top the circular is not very circular, it's a very low poly. It's about how many? 8 polygons. This is way too low. It caused problems when we added a subdivision. Alright, let's go to the top view and add a bunch of edges to these faces. Alright, make it a bit more round. Bit more rounder, alright. Select all these edges. All these. Alright, after we select all these edges, we right click, connect. Now we add bunch of more edges to the circular shape. Now we select one face, shift select another faces. Now we have select all the faces that contain 16 polygons, and we use regularizer to circular the shape. Regularize is basically a script that circularizes the faces or edges like in Maya. Now click on regularize. I put the link in the description so you can download this script. Regularize, nice. Now we have a much better circular on top. Beautiful. Select these edges, regularize again. Now we have nice. Okay, and now we have to add a. Now we can use multiple tools for adding the support edge loop to this object. We can use a cut tool. Right click it, cut tool, cut through the model. We can use a connect tool. Select all these edges. Use connect. Use two segment, increase pinching. This is one method. Another method is just select the edges we want to be sharp, like here, like on the box. We want all the box to be perfectly sharp. We use a chamfer like that. We change the chamfer type to quad chamfer, set the tension, edge tension to 0. Alright, decrease the value here, something like that. Now we have a support edge loops. Nice. Another method is just go to the edge sub object level, go to the edit sweep loop and insert edge loop right here. But as you can see here, if we add a sweep loop, it goes all through the model. It ruined the circular, ruined the cylinder here. It's not very good. So we have to be careful. All right, let's begin. go to the right view, use the easiest method is just connect. Select these edges, right click, connect. We collect by two segments, pinch like 80, plus do the same thing here, select all these edges, it's plus. Be careful not to double click this button. Now here we select all these edges, we increase the pinching to like 95, because it's a longer dead face and it's a bit more value. Select all these, decrease the pinching, 90 plus, do the same here, decrease the pinching, 85 plus, exit, cancel. Now we have to add a edge loop here. We can use the insert, select face, right click, insert, insert it. I bet in the Maya you can use a extrude to insert the face, select these faces on top, but quickly select all these faces. We can use shift, hold shift and just select, or we can go to the by angle, set the angle to like 5 degrees and just click it. Deselect by angle, go to the insert, insert by low value like that. Nice. We do the same. Alright, hey, yes, we do the same on top. Select all these edges. Let's do it by value. Select it, deselect by angle, insert. Nice. We need to add a superposal here. We can use a swift loop. Go to the edit, swift loop, add one here. Nice. Let's remove these edge loops here. Alright, now we need to add support edge loops to these edges. The best tools for this kind of corners is to chamfer. We select the edges that we want to be sharp, like here on the corner. We select all four sides. Be sure to not go through the model. If it's because it's a triangle here, it doesn't go through all of it. You stop here at this angle. Alright, nice. Good on bottom. On top, we need to deselect. We go to the wireframe and click, hold Alt and deselect it. Just here. Nice. Alright. Right click and chamfer it. Use a chamfer as chamfer value 0.21, iteration to 0, and okay, nice. Now we have to connect these vertices because we have a big, huge, ugly end gun on top, and it causes a tension and problem for us. If I add a turbo smooth on top, you see here we got a very bad result. What is it? This is bad. Let's go to the editable poly and connect these faces to create a quad. We need all these faces to be quad. Just quad. In rare cases like this, it's okay on the flat surface to have a triangle or angon, doesn't matter. Like this is angon, who cares? It's a flat surface, nobody care. All right, do the same thing here. Connect, select these edges, connect, select this one, connect to make it beautiful. All right, now we delete these edges to get rid of it and make it quad. We can select only these two, go to the modify in the ribbon, modify selection, hit similar, and it will select all the rest for us, except this one. Alright, hit Control Delete to get rid of the vertices as well. Now we have quad. Oh, we forgot about this one as well. It's okay. Select this vertices and this and connect. Nice. Alright, I think we need to add this. Insert another support edge loop through here. Now I just go to the edges, edit speed loop, and insert the edge right here. I had a shortcut for the speed loop like X on my keyboard. I just simply just select the tools way faster. Alright, let's add the turbo smooth on top and look at the model. Nice. Now we have, oh, we have a problem here. Damn. Let's see what's happened. Alright, we forgot to add a chamfer modifier to chamfer tool. These edges obviously don't have a support edge loop. Man, because of this problem, simply by cut tool, cut through the model here. We go all the way down. It's a bit tricky. Select here. Again, go through all the way here and delete these triangles. Go to the edge sub-object level and hold Control Delete. Select this one as well. Now we have quads. Nice. Let's look at our model. Beautiful. Let's increase the iteration to like 2 or 3. And look at it. Nice. Oops, here we go. As I told you before, this method, it will cause a lot of problems, but it's okay. I'm glad this happened. I show you how to get rid of this problem. Now we good. Let's try that again. And we have our high poly model. Nice. If we can increase the tension by just simply moving up the edges on top to make it a bit more sharper or softer. Like we here. We have a sharper edge on top. Alright. Alright guys, this one, the parts one for creating a high poly model using the first method, which is adding the support edge loops. And be sure to subscribe and hit the thumbs up button. See you guys next time. Bye bye.